Were you ever a movie fan?
I'm a big movie fan.
Palagay ko we are where we are. And I mean, lahat tayo because we are movie fans, no? Kanino ka, I mean, sino talagang hinangaan mo, Liza?
Ito lang, nagkita lang kami recently. Ito yung mga perks of being a chair. Pala, I got the chance to really talk to Tita Jane, si Jacqueline Jose.
Wow.
Ate Guy. As in, nag-uusap kami na parang, you know, hindi siya yung iba.
Totoo ba ito?
Oo, may ganun. Oo, magkatabi ko na, tinawag pa, ma'am. Huh? Ganun siya. And Congressman V. I mean, for me, ito yung pillars ng institution na sila sa showbiz. And of course, I'm an actress. At the end of the day,
that's right.
Even with this position, andun pa rin yung puso ko sa pag-arte. So, to meet them, to be with them, and to actually have this one-on-one conversation with them is...
Surreal.
Surreal. Surreal.
Surreal talaga siya. Surreal. Are you a fan?
Yes. Talaga. Alam mo, dati, lagi ako nag... Kunyari, gabi na, kasi I don't sleep early. Nasa Cinema One ako. Dati, 21 siya, Channel 21 dati.
Totoo.
So yun, lahat ng mga paulit-ulit, yung mga Ninyo Mula kasama na maliit pa siya, pinapanood ko yan.
Ay, ikaw, Teddy?
Oh, ako, medyo mas may edad na ako kasi nagsisenior.
Iba yung mga i-mention niya.
Kaya, mas matagal na yung nakaraan natin. No? Yung... I really got involved in Philippine cinema. No? I was not exactly a movie fan, but I just want, the first time I saw, for example, some of these early films by our great filmmakers who are now national artists like Jerry De Leon, no? Like Manuel Conde, I was fascinated. And sabi ko, ang gagaling nila, no? My God, we had a great past. Filipino cinema was great.
Of course.
No? But what is wrong? Because a lot of these films are gone. Kaya hindi natin.
So that's how you got into preservation.
I got into restoration, and retrieval. No, so you know, in 1982, one of my first jobs, no, probably my first film job.
That was a great year for Philippine cinema.
82, yes.
Great year.
The year of Himala.
Yes. Madami yon. Sabay-sabay.
There was a retrospective that was being organized by the ECP, no? I don't know if people remember
Experimental
Cinema of the Philippines under Aimee Marcos. And Lino Broja, at that time, before he became a renegade, a rebel, he was cooperating with the government and he was tasked with organizing a retrospective for the great Jerry De Leon, who had just been declared a national artist. And somehow, I got into his... Through a friend, I got into a circle and he asked me if I would like to join in this committee to retrieve and organize the films and organize a retrospective. And so I joined. Never in my wildest imagination did I think that I would be the one to retrieve and actually locate some of the films. And then we brought it together.
Oh, the great Jerry De Leon.
Yes, wow. Films like Noli Me Tangere, El Filibusterismo, and a real find, Moises Padilla's story, which we had to bring back from Davao, no? Because the producer lived there.
Pero hindi ka nakipag-away dahil sa isang artista. Katulad namin.
Hindi naman, no?
Kami ng kapatid ko kasi, si Manang, totoo yun, diehard Vilmanian. I was a rabid Noranian.
Oh,
so para sa akin, pag sinasabi ng kapatid ko na, negra, hindi, maputi si Ate Guy. Alam mo yun, yung as children, you know, I grew up in that generation when you were either a Noranian or a Vilmanian. Of course, I have so much respect for V, and we have become very, very good friends.
And now the restored films are being shown. It's the same crowd. They have that same energy inside the theater if
galing,
you
no?
watch.
That's true. That's why it's important that we know our past, our history, our cinematic history.